Did you ever wonder why the news is referred to as the press? You can thank Gutenberg for that one. And I bring it up because today I'm going to be talking about the way that humans share information. And for this topic, there's no better place to start out than with the printing press. And so what we'll do is start off by going back to before it was even a thing in the 1400s, when the best way to share information was to write down copies of it over and over and over again. Now, you can imagine that this was not the best method, and it was prone to all sorts of issues, at least in the Western world, where books would have misspellings and missing information and just problems. I do want to point out that over in China, they actually did have a sort of printing with wooden blocks, but it wasn't nearly as efficient as what was about to hit the scene from our good old friend Johannes Gutenberg, who was this German guy that we really don't know much about. But we do know that he was able to combine random technologies that existed during his time, like a wine press, and put them together in different ways to come up with a new tool of mass text-producing ability, what we call the printing press. It's not just that he created a way of forming individual metal letters and then developing a way of arranging them so they could be, quote-unquote, pressed onto pages of a pamphlet, but he also had to come up with things like an ink and one that would work on a cheap parchment. The result was a great bang for the buck. Books were now able to be manufactured quickly, cheaply, and accurately. The idea caught on, and soon there were hundreds of printing presses and millions of books. And they were printing all sorts of different things, from Bibles to accounts of random people like Columbus talking about a new world. So you can imagine that this may have had an impact on history. And of course it did. One of the biggest examples of this is the famous case of Martin Luther posting his 95 Theses on a church in 1517. He was protesting the Catholic Church during the time, and they were about to lose control of information. And his writings spread like wildfire. Martin Luther is really the original best-selling author. And one could argue that his writings went viral, which brings me to the internet. Because, you see, I believe the two are linked. In my mind, these two communication mediums, the internet and the printing press, are kind of like two rungs on a ladder with something like human speech at the bottom and internet at the current top. And I say this because I think the internet has made its mark. And I'm not under any delusions. I realize that it's not the only communication innovation since the printing press, because there's plenty of other ones like the telegraph and radio and television. But I think the internet is different. It rises to the level of the press because both of these innovations caused a great democratization of information. Yes, the radio and television allowed for the sharing of information, but it wasn't at necessarily the grassroots level or with the written word. Just think about how easy it is on the internet today to write or read an article or even download a book. People might disagree. It's really just an evolution of the path initiated by the Gutenberg press and not necessarily a next step. But I disagree, because if you use this same logic, the printing press itself could be interpreted as an evolution of handwriting. And so it wouldn't be distinctive either. And I'm saying the internet is on the same level as the printing press. And I know what you're thinking. So what's the modern 95 Theses? And it's hard to say, but it could be something like WikiLeaks. We right now are in the midst of the history. We are living the history. So it's really hard to define the impact of the internet on the world. So really, time will tell. And I'll leave it at that. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video. And I hope you got something out of it. So until next time, have a good one.